Praise the Lord. I don't know, we had some technical difficulties, but that's all right. The devil is a liar. So in order to move on, we're talking about truth. He says, put on, gird yourself with truth. Truth represents the truth about Jesus, his calling, his purpose, and the duties of man. That represents truth. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. So Jesus wants us, in order to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might, you've got to know truth. Amen? Then he says, put on the breastplate of righteousness. And that consists of, you've got to know and understand what God calls righteous, or what God calls righteous, which you living a righteous lifestyle, you living a righteous way of life. And the other part, the gospel, having your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace, that deals with the gospel message being your foundation. And that gospel message relates to the good news of the kingdom of God, which is in Christ Jesus. So we know that the gospel is about the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, but it's also about receiving grace and receiving mercy. Thank you, Lord. It's a lot in that gospel, and it rests as your foundation. And notice he said, your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. That means that everywhere you go, that gospel represents your foundation and your ability to stand up against the wiles of the devil, because it's your foundation. Notice, then he says, and also the Roman soldiers, they had cleats on their shoes, they had to go up some tough terrain. They were able to go up the tough terrain, and they also used those cleats in war in case they had to step on their opponent. And that's what the gospel represents. You can use it as a weapon of warfare, and you can use it to climb up, thank you, Lord, over tests and trials that the enemy is sending your way. Notice the next one is the shield of faith. And the shield of faith, which is to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one, that shield represents your conviction about the truth. You're being persuaded. Faith cometh by hearing, and that by the word of God. So faith helps you to believe God and to believe his word. Amen. And the enemy, he attacks your faith. So you got to take that shield, amen, to quench all of his, notice what it says, fiery darts. And the only way you can quench a fiery dart, you got to keep your shield oiled. And that's the anointing. So you got to keep your faith anointed. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. So you can believe God. Notice, then he says, having on the salvation, helmet of salvation, and that represents keeping yourself delivered, knowing that you have been delivered. The devil, he likes to bring thoughts to condemn us. Thank you, Lord, to condemn us. And knowing that you've been saved, he's an accuser of the brethren. Knowing that you've been saved, set free, the devil makes you to try to doubt that you've been saved, if thou be the Son of God, and tries to make you think that you've sinned and fallen short. So what the scripture talks about, salvation, is knowing that you're delivered, that you're preserved, that you're safe. Any treated wood, it's preserved. You can have rainstorms on it. Thank you, Lord. It won't spoil. It won't rot. Why? Because it's been preserved. You as a Christian, and because you have salvation, you can't spoil. You can't rot. You're safe. You're safe. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. You're safe. Amen. That's what that salvation. and use the word of God to fight against the wiles of the devil, to fight, amen, against the enemy. You tell him, it is written. Hallelujah. You use the word. I'm not sick, but I'm healed. I declare and decree. That's, you got to know that part of the word. Amen. And then you got to know how to pray. The scripture talks about praying with all supplication. And then it talks about watching. You also got to watch. Amen. Keep your eye on the prize. Don't be weary in well-doing. Don't allow yourself to be distracted. In other words, you can be having fun with people, but as soon as something goes south, you know, you switch and change on them because you're watching. You're not one that's like a butterfly, just flying with no purpose, no habits. You're trusting in God. You're believing in God, and you're watching. So I'm going to come back next week, Lord will, and finish this up, really nail it to the ground. And I thank God that you have tuned in with us on today. And we're talking about being strong in the Lord. The Bible tells us we got to put on the whole armor of God that we might be able to stand and withstand against the wiles of the devil. And you have to live a crucified life. What do you mean, Pastor, when you say a crucified life? You got to live a lifestyle that represents holiness and righteousness. Because if you're not adding this armor in totality, there's going to be areas of weakness that the enemy will penetrate and take advantage of you. So therefore, he says, you got to put on the whole armor of God. Live a lifestyle that's worthy of holiness, that's worthy of righteousness, so that God, amen, can infuse you with his power and with his anointing. So we thank God, amen, once again. And let us pray. Gracious Father, we thank you for this Bible study on tonight. We thank you for the anointing that we have on the inside, the hope of salvation. We pray, Lord, that these words have gone out and have penetrated the hearts of the hearers so that they'll become doers of your word. And Lord, we thank you for each and every soul on tonight. Every soul is precious unto you, Lord. Every soul is worthy unto you, Lord. And Lord, we thank you and praise you for each and every one of them. Those that may be in struggle, those that may be going through, we ask you, Lord, that you send them some help, send them some strength, send them some glory. Right now in the name of Jesus. Father, we praise you, give you glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. We certainly do thank you for this word that we've had with you on today. Please join us for our next broadcast, which will be on Sunday, Lord will, starting at 9:30 for our Sunday school and 11 o'clock for our morning worship. May God bless you. May heaven smile upon you. And may the Lord continue to be on your side. And those that are members of Christian Ministries, want to remind you of your tithes and your offerings. Thank you, Lord. And in Jesus' name, so that you might receive your blessing. We thank God for you. In Jesus' name, amen.